Please be ready for a dictation of part 3 of a material taken from the Wikipedia on the Supreme Court of India, which can be suitable for DDC PA skill and any other skill exam. 5 seconds. Start. A bench may refer a case before it to a larger bench should the need arise. Cases involving interpretation of the Constitution are heard by at least a 5-judge bench as provided under Article 145(3). The largest ever bench at the Supreme Court of India has been constituted in 1973 in Kesava Nanda Bharati versus State of Kerala. A bench of 13 judges was set up to decide whether Parliament had the unfettered right to amend the Constitution or not, that eventually gave rise to the basic structure doctrine. The Constitution seeks to ensure the independence of Supreme Court judges in various ways. Per Article 50 of Directive Principles of State Policy, the state shall take steps to separate the judiciary from the executive. Independence of the judiciary, the supremacy of the Constitution, and rule of law are the features of the basic structure of the Constitution. Supreme Court and High Courts are empowered to frame suo moto cases without receiving the formal petitions, complaints on any suspected injustice, including acts indulging in contempt of court and contempt of the Constitution by the executive, legislators, citizens, etc. It is considered as one of the most independent court in the whole Southeast Asia. The main purpose of Supreme Court is to decide constitutional issues. It is the duty of the judiciary to frame suo moto cases or to probe the cases, petitions at the earliest against the executive or legislature when laws are implemented violating the basic foundation and basic structure of the Constitution as the Article 38(1) of Directive Principles ensures that the state judiciary shall strive to promote the welfare of the people by securing a social order in which social, economic, and political justice is animated, informed in all institutions of life. Per the Constitution, as held by the court in the 3 judges' cases, 1982, 1993, 1998, a judge is appointed to the Supreme Court by the President on the recommendation of the Collegium, a closed group of the Chief Justice of India, the 4 most senior judges of the court, and the senior most judge hailing from the High Court of a prospective appointee. This has resulted in a memorandum of procedure being followed for the appointments. Judges used to be appointed by the President on the advice of the Union Cabinet. After 1993, the 2 judges' case, no minister or even the executive collectively can suggest any names to the President, who ultimately decides on appointing them from a list of names recommended only by the Collegium of the judiciary. Simultaneously, as held in that judgment, the executive was given the power to reject a recommended name. However, according to some, the executive has not been diligent in using this power to reject the names of bad candidates recommended by the judiciary. The Collegium system has come under a fair amount of criticism. In 2015, the Parliament passed a law to replace the Collegium with a national judicial appointments commission. This was struck down as unconstitutional by the Supreme Court in the fourth judge's case, as the new system would undermine the independence of the judiciary. Stop.